The Zimbabwean government says the country is emerging from a recent wave of panic buying that saw shops run out of goods and motorists spend long hours in lines at gas stations. But as Columbus Mavhunga reports from Harare, Zimbabwe's economic problems are far from over.
For weeks now, there have been long and winding queues at most fuel stations in Zimbabwe as the precious liquid has been in short supply. Bus driver Lameki Mauriri is one of those tired of waiting in line.
We are sleeping in queues. There's no fuel, there's no bread, there's no drinks. Everything is, there's nothing. There's no cash, no jobs.
Many shops in Harare have empty shelves. Businessman Christopher Farai Teza says the fuel shortage makes it hard to transport food supplies.
Shortages of diesel forces prices of most goods to go up, as happened last week. There was panic buying as people rushed to stock up on expensive items like sugar and cooking oil.
Zimbabweans use foreign currency to conduct most transactions, and there isn't enough to go around. The introduction of bond notes, a currency the government started printing 2 years ago, has not helped because the bond notes are hard to find and do not have the public's confidence.
What they've done is to increase, for example, money supply in the economy. And that money supply is not actually backed by improvements, significant improvements in productivity. And when that happens, that's a recipe for economic disaster.
Zimbabwe's government says the markets for food and oil are stabilizing.
We didn't have any shortages. What we had was scramble for essential commodities. The scramble was caused by panic. People were panic buying a lot of things. And hence, when you have a surge of people all going to one place, there has to be some order. And order is what you call queues.
Despite government assurances, some lines do not appear to be getting any shorter and prices continue to rise. Columbus Mavhunga for VOA News, Harare.